The following tape was recorded in Broad Street United Methodist Church, February the 24th, 1974, at the 11th hour service. A service of consecration. The Shantz 38th rank 3-manual pipe organ. This tape is presented to the church by the Organ Music Committee for historical purposes. Buford Guy, Chairman. Joe G. Rogers, Sr., deceased. Mr. and Mrs. Creel Higgins. H.S. Albritton. Jack Allen. Mrs. W.T. Blevins. Mrs. Wayne Fear. Mrs. Lois Harrell. Mrs. Coleman Sawyer. Mrs. Sterling Turner, transferred.
celebrate the goodness of life and adore the giver of life. Let us make the walls and what rafters ring with our praise. In this sanctuary, let us praise him. Let the crowd on the street and in the town hear and know that he made us, and that we did not make ourselves. Let us stand and sing joyfully, praise the Lord who reigns above. Some 70 years ago, someone dreamed of a richness and variety in music that could not be attained with a piano. Putting their dream into faithful practice, a pipe organ was installed in this sanctuary. That was no small feat in a small town at the turn of the century. Of course, singing can be done with a piano. But somebody knew about variety and depth and harmony that would expand our worship. And we have enjoy the fruits of that labor. And then in 1942, Mrs. C.L. Hardwick refurbished and expanded until we had a new organ with a larger capacity and a greater variety in depth. And for 31 years, we have enjoyed that gift. A gift given to the honor and glory of God. I've never been privileged to serve in a church with a pipe organ before. And I didn't really know what I had missed. But after I'd been here a few Sundays and then was away, the service seemed hollow and empty. And then all of you know what we experienced when we were moved out of here for a couple of months. There seemed to be something missing. And some of you who grew up with this instrument may never have known what you had. And so we today celebrate those who dream big dreams and were faithful in the past. But we come to celebrate also the present or the immediate past. Some of us were privileged to watch craftsmen at work in this sanctuary. We thought they were to move this area ahead 30 inches, close in the gaps and open up these areas that had been enclosed in 1942. And we sat in amazement at men who worked not just to earn money and to do a job, but who worked as craftsmen. And he called in one day and said, "Preacher, climb up on the ladder. We want you to see something. There's a rotten piece up there that nobody will ever see, but we can't in good conscience leave it. Is it all right if we go ahead and fix that? That's not in the contract." I said, "Sure." They said, "Nobody will see it, but we'll know it." And while they were messing around, not at that place, but another place, they hammered and found nothing. Then they discovered that our ceiling was about to join us in the pew. And for 2 months, they did an amazing job of putting this back as it was, ripping out the beams, replacing and restoring. Those of us who watched were inspired to again offer our lives to God as workmen, as craftsmen who were proud and who gave to God a good gift. And then a simple task like cleaning these stained glass windows. A man who did it with fear and trembling lest he push out one of the small pieces of glass. And yet the new beauty. The painters who very carefully did their work. Those who rewired. We're celebrating today hands that are skilled and hearts that are proud. Workmen who present their work unto God, a thing to be grasped and used sincerely. How could we celebrate today without remembering a hard-working music committee that traveled all over Tennessee and North Carolina and who knows where else, who brought the plans for this magnificent new instrument and who worked through to its completion. We remember with eternal gratitude Joe Rogers Sr., who chaired that group, who now is enjoying the service from another sphere. How could we celebrate today without celebrating our choirs? The hours they give, the separation from their families in worship, the contribution they made to our service. How can we celebrate today without a special word of appreciation to Krill and Joyce Higgins? You've had them so long. And they've done so well that I doubt you really appreciate them. You've gotten used to excellence. And I just want to ask you sometime to listen when you're somewhere else and try to sing with some other organs. We may not have the best, but we haven't found the best in other places, some other ones. And so we celebrate this day, the past, the present. How can we celebrate the careful work that's been done in here without celebrating Horace and Essie, who for 3 months enabled us to go on in other places and picked up the mess, and who keep our building gleaming so we're the envy of other churches and firms. This is a day of appreciation, a day of celebration. If I don't hush, Bob's going to be pulling on my robe because he's got some time to go. The people like Dr. Lumonte, who served here, others who were invited but couldn't come because of the gasoline shortage and other matters, Marcus, and all in all. What a day this is to offer thanks to God for the past, to celebrate every good and beautiful and wonderful thing that has happened through the skill and love and faithfulness of others. You'll note that I reversed the procedure because I wanted you now to celebrate with me in this beautiful litany our thanksgiving and our praise. Our Father and our Lord, we declare before you and before one another that we love you and want to obey you, despite many fears, hesitations, and doubts. For the joys we taste and see and hear, for the good things and happy occasions that inspire us to praise you, accept our gratitude. We remember especially those who lead us in making music of our praise. For composers of melody and poetry, for hymn writers and singers of hymns, for choirs and congregations, for those who play instruments and those who delight in their playing, we give you hearty thanks. Make a joyful noise all the earth. Give to him glorious praise. Let all people praise him. For the sounds of music with which we express the mystery and wonder of life, and make known the heights and depths in you, we are grateful. For old sounds and new sounds, for loud sounds and soft sounds, for low sounds and new sounds, for bass sounds and treble sounds, for reed sounds, brass sounds, and flute sounds, for the sounds of music, thank you, O Creator of all that was, is, and shall be. Sing to the Lord a new song. Let everyone praise the name of the Lord, for his name is high above all others. The rhythms of music, through which we make known our happiness and the night divide in your loving and gracious will, we rejoice. For stately rhythms and majestic rhythms, for fun rhythms and brief rhythms, for rhythms of rapture and ecstasy, for smooth, flowing rhythms, and rhythms that start and awaken, for the rhythms of drum and cymbal, hear our praise, O Lord of all.
Bless the Lord, O my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Serve the Lord with gladness.
For this instrument which we hereby offer and consecrate unto you, receive our special praise. To all who made it and saw it safely to this place, to all who assembled and perfected it, that together we should honor you, grant safety and well-being. May wood, metal, and other things gathered from the abundance of your good world, fashioned into a work of beauty, harmony, and craftsmanship, truly be a sacrament to all who play it and to all who hear it. For this place renewed to receive it, for those who so carefully repaired, cleaned, and prepared it, we give grateful thanks. Enter these doors with thanksgiving. This is sanctuary for praise. Praise Him with stringed instruments and organs. Amen.
Firmament. Praise Him for His mighty deeds. Praise Him according to His exceeding greatness. Praise Him with trumpet sound. Praise Him with lute and harp. Praise Him with timbrel and dance. Praise Him with strings and pipe. Praise Him with sounding cymbals. Praise Him with loud flashing cymbals. Let everything that breathes praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let us stand praising the Lord and affirm our faith to the Apostles' Creed, number 738. Let us unite in this historic confession of the Christian faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, His only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day He rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven, and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From then he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe. believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. us continue our praising as we turn to him in the spirit of prayer. Most kind and gracious Heavenly Father, on this very special day, we are made to realize that we gather here at this place at this time not to celebrate ourselves and not to give praise for what we have done, but to sing songs of praise and thanksgiving for what you have done and for what you have given us. We would just like to just lift up these things for which we're so thankful. Just the small things of life, sunshine that hits our shoulders, the laughter of a very small child, the wisdom spoken from the lips of an aged mind, sounds of silence, the goodness of the earth which we enjoy, to be able to see, to hear, to smell, to touch, walk around, to be able to sing, we're thankful for all these things and many more, but particularly we are thankful for the gift you have given us in thy Son, who has made us aware of all these things of life, which we call beauty, and who has made us aware of a life that is even more beautiful than that which we know. As we offer to you our praise and our thanksgiving, we bid you come, be present with us, and hear our praise, and may we feel you to be present with us, and may we feel your love pour down upon each of our hearts and fill them in abundance, making them whole, making them complete, that we may know peace. Hear our prayers, each one. The prayers of thanksgiving, the prayers of confession, the prayers prayed with uncertainty, the prayers of assurance. Prayer our Lord taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, the glory, forever. Thanksgiving to celebrate this magnificent order. presence makes it even more beautiful and even more magnificent. We welcome all of you who are visiting with us. May you record your visits with us that we might keep up with who has visited. This evening, we will conclude our mission study. We will return to a covered dish supper, hoping that that's more attractive than snack supper in the form of sandwiches. We hope to see each of you there in your place. May we continue to worship our Lord and our God this time by presenting to him ourselves in the form of our tithes and offerings. good-looking, young, blonde-haired, blue-eyed recruiter of the Nazi Party appears on the screen singing the most beautiful song entitled "Tomorrow Belongs to Me." The song tells of a dream of Germany that is to come about through the workings of the Nazi Party. As the young man sings this song in a very beautiful countryside setting, the viewer is very quickly aware that he is emotionally drawn into that song, and he wants to dream with the young man and sing along that "Tomorrow Belongs to Me." Yet it does not take a very serious study of history for us to realize that many dreams become nightmares. As we stand before this magnificent Shantz organ, with the privileged, once-in-a-lifetime task of consecration, we must celebrate the future of this organ. I would not have us think that we stand only before a collection of wood and pieces of metal artistically woven by the hands of craftsmen into this beautiful, lovely instrument. We stand this day before a dream. And this dream must be intricately worked out by our crafty hands, else it too may become a nightmare, avoiding any catastrophe. This organ should say something to each of us who are presently here consecrating its future. We will not see the total life of this organ. That should be overpowering enough. This organ will long outlive any one of us here today. We will be but a small part of its future. For those who are still yet unborn, are those, and only those, who can stand with this organ and dream and sing that tomorrow belongs to me. But our part in the future of this organ, as small in time as it may be, is extremely important. As we consecrate its future, we define a dream. And we set forth from this point working out and unfolding that dream. We define tomorrow's dream for our children and for their children. And it is our daily task to see that that dream becomes a reality. But what is our dream? And how shall we work it out? Possibly the best way this can be expressed in the form of an answer is by seeing how we might want to use this organ in the lives of our children and their children, those yet even still unborn. Initially, we will want in the spring of their lives a very soft, joyful, fluty sound at the moment of their birth and at the moment of their baptism when they are brought into the family of God. And we will want to add during the summer of their lives a more secure, bassy note to lead them and guide them in their first steps. And certainly we will want to add the mighty blast of the trumpet when they stand before us as young adults, confirming that Jesus is their Lord. And we will want to act in the fall of their lives, the stately wedding march, as these products of love become lovers themselves and have dreams for their children. But during the winter months, we will want to add the comforting strings and horns that will heal their mourning hearts and that will enable them to walk through the valley shadowed by their own death, triumphant, dignified, trusting manner to their eternal tomorrow. Throughout these seasons, we will want to add that ecstatic, joyful song of thanksgiving and praise which we just sung, holy, 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 Lord God Almighty. And we will want to add the inviting, fulfilling sounds of communion as broken bread and poured wine are served to the tune, "Let us break bread together," on our knees. And none of us would want the organ to miss playing the incarnated carol of Christmas, brightened by the power of candles, "Joy to the world, for the Lord has come." And we will be eager to add to all this the topping on the cake and add the message of Easter that he lives. He lives. But to be sure, our dream will only be complete when the music of this organ reveals the uneven, the discordant aspects of life. We will want to add those melodies which will cause our children to be ever minded of the sorrow, the depressed, the poor, the needy, the oppressed, in such a way that they will want to confess their sins and the sins of us, their Father, as they pray, "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth, as it constantly is being done in heaven." Our dream is that through this organ, our children and we ourselves might be drawn into a more complete realization of the present love God has for each of us, the love God has revealed for each of us in the person of Jesus, whom we call Lord. May we never fail and allow this dream to become an eternal nightmare of death for even one person who might decide to worship with us here at this time in this place. But as we consecrate the future of this organ, may the music flow from it softly and quietly, that our Lord might come to us in silence. But may it also come loudly and with much dynamic and with much force, so that even the dead might hear us sing, "Rise up, O men of God. Your Father waits for you. Tomorrow belongs to him." So leave. Amen. It is my privilege to introduce to you at this time Reverend Dr. James Hankins, who has been affiliated with this church for some time, who is currently the district superintendent of the Cleveland District. He will now lead us in the consecration of our Lord.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, we consecrate this organ to the praise of Almighty God. Of the great doxologies of the church, and to the development of the language of praise which belongeth both to earth and to heaven. Consecrate this organ to the wedding march, to thanksgiving on festival occasions, and to such inspiration in the service of song that all people may praise the Lord.
Sing unto the Lord a new song. Sing unto the Lord all the earth in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs. Sing and make melody in your heart to the Lord.
We consecrate this organ to the healing of life's discord, to the revealing of the hidden soul of harmony, to the lifting of the depressed and the comforting of the sorrowing, to the humbling of the heart before the eternal mysteries, and the lifting of the soul to abiding beauty and joy by the gospel of infinite love and goodwill.
Let us stand and sing.
277. Let us stand.
Standing there, I'm going to ask him if he would give our benediction.
And you'll all stay around to visit. We're not in any hurry today, I hope. And if you are visiting from afar, make yourself known to some of us who are new, and let's have a good time and fellowship together. Dr. Lundy.
Our Father, thou hast heard our praise and thanksgiving this day. Help us to go forth and march in the tempo of this music and of this glad hour, reflecting glory upon thyself, upon even Jesus Christ, our Savior, and that we may reflect thy glory until we hear the triumphant chorus singing in the open world. Our prayer is in Jesus' name.
Thank you.